Walkman now in that what has been 5 days since we recorded the last episode. Now it's at 1.8 million streams on Spotify.
What?
We're gonna hit like almost two and.
Hey man,
weeks.
we don't even talk about these numbers to be like, ah, look at the numbers we doing, bro. It's just
so much bigger than anything we put out last. So it's just cool to see that. I don't know.
And music is something that is just so much fun, you know. And we have zero. I have all the expectation that people hear it and go, this shit sucks.
Yeah, it's cool that we have fun making it. We have fun shooting this shit, and then when people listen to it, they have fun.
Yeah. And like that's, yeah, they enjoy
that
it.
That is actually like kind of fulfilling.
Yeah, the fact that like it's all kind of, you know, everyone's having a good time.
Yeah,
100%. And it's funny that so when it hit trending, a bunch of dudes reacted to it, and like there's a lot of dudes that don't realize that we're not joking.
Yeah. So what did they say?
So some dudes was like watching and they go, yo, like one guy, he watched it, he's like he goes on that first like ad lib cutaway to me like rolling my eyes up. He's like, yo, what's up with that face? He's like, I don't know if I would have did that.
It's fucking weird how comedy confuses people.
Yeah,
it like, makes them like it fucks with them. Because I agree. As a human, it's like hard. You want to categorize things. It's natural.
Yeah.
You want to put things in buckets. We've talked about this before.
Yeah.
But it's like something can be two things at once.
Sure.
But people just don't understand that.
Yeah, it fucks them up when if it's like it's just not straight up comedy. Like it's like
we need to like put a label on these guys. Okay, yeah. They're meme rappers. Oh.
Yeah.
Okay, now I can fucking relax because now I can digest what's happening.
Yeah,
you know, it's like no, but they could just like someone in Young Gravy did an AMA and someone was like, "Would you categorize yourself as a meme rapper?" And he was like, "Man, it's like I just make music. Like if I go in the booth and I say some funny shit,
then it's funny.
It's just funny. Like I just like I have it on my mind and I want to say this funny stuff. Like."
Yeah.
It's like if you can still like bounce to it and enjoy it, like
yeah, what does it matter?
I guess I'm a meme rapper then, sure.
Yeah. I mean, I would like.
I'm not saying we're meme rappers or whatever. Nah. It's just like it's funny how comedy. It's just like people are like, what is this? Am I supposed to take it seriously? Am I not? It's music, isn't it?
I think now more than ever, like you're starting to like see a little bit more acceptance of like comedy in rap.
Mm-hmm.
I think rap. You know, hip hop in general has always been like, and as it should be, like sort of serious and like come from like a point of like penmanship kind of thing. But I like that's why I like Sean Price so much is like as tough as he was as a person and like all the shit he went through. He like in the middle of his verses would have just funny ass bars and like some of them were hard, some of them were just straight up funny. But like that was the first time I felt like. He's an artist in my mind that I feel like was both. Like he embraced being both. Like he's like, yeah, I'm from Brownsville and I sold drugs and I'm about it and I've lived that life, but that doesn't mean I can't be a clown. Like he would film tons of sketches. Like he was like the first rapper I felt like really trying to do that, like and duck down like the label, like really like backed him on that. That this whole bit where he like he takes over Duck Down. And like he just took a day to like shoot a whole bit, like kind of office style, where he's like going around the office and like fucking with the A&Rs and the creative people, and like I think that was all his idea. Then he did some other shit where he like went to play tennis, and like how he's talking about like oh this is like white people shit, and it's like it's just really funny. But he was willing to like put himself out of his element, like be goofy, and
yeah,
you know I feel like most like rappers and stuff they, you know, it's not to say that he's the first person to do that, but I think more often than not, rappers and just artists in general are not willing to joke about themselves. Like, I kind of think they, like, put themselves as, like, okay, if I'm a rapper, I got to be that. If I'm a singer, I got
to
be that.
I mean, to a certain degree, like, it does help. Context helps, like, create a certain mood.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah,
if you're
yeah.
listening to a song that's supposed to be, like, dramatic and supposed to make you sad and feel you, like, The Weeknd, like, you couldn't listen to his first mixtape. If he had funny shit in there, you'd be like,
100%.
You'd be like, okay, this kind of ruins it. Right? 100%. But like, it's funny that you see more and more of a blend nowadays.
Yeah.
Like, where, like, Oliver Tree, perfect example. Like,
yeah.
Like, are you supposed to take it seriously? Are you not? Like, mm-hmm. His music is just good.
Yeah.
But people get so fucking confused. Like,
yeah.
Where where it's like, I don't understand the meme and whatever. Yeah, it's yeah, like, yeah, maybe yeah. he just wants to be funny all the time.
Yeah, yeah.
But he still makes great music.
Right, right. I think that's definitely like the coolest part of, I don't know, the internet or whatever. Like, we can enjoy like making this shit. And if people are like, yo, this is like corny, it's like, that's fine. Like, what if it's supposed to be kind of thing?
Yeah.
Like, it's okay if it's corny. Like,
yeah. Yeah.
I don't know. I'm just trying to say, like, I think now more than ever, you see a lot of artists like trying to ride a line, or like they blend, is basically what you're saying. Like, they don't, shit can be two at once. Mm-hmm. I'm basically just reiterating your point. But yeah, no, I agree. People definitely, you saw that, like, with all the reaction videos, like what we were doing. Like, you could see people like really struggle, they're really trying to figure it out.
Yeah. I mean, which I think can be like a bad thing. But I think it could also be a good thing. I don't know. Because I think branding and I think context is important. I'm not saying that.
Yeah.
Like, I've always said that it's really important and, like, you have to nail a mood and whatever. But I think, like, this is a new one.
I think...
Like, this weird middle area where it's... I'm not saying we're, like, creating any fucking, like, new genres or whatever. But I'm saying, like, people like Young Gravy and stuff like that, to me, are, like, riding the line so well that it's creating this whole, like...
Yeah. Or
like subgenre of like comedy music that's not comedy. It's just light and funny.
I think like shout out to fucking,
I'm gonna get heat for that too.
No, I mean, shout out to these guys, Das Racist.
Yeah, them too.
Yeah, 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 yeah. They what I love about them, bro, is their music to me is so like reminiscent of like when me and my friends are like just freestyle in the car and we fuck around.
Yeah.
And like just say funny shit. Like their music, you know, I don't know what their process is, but there's something like real genuine about that. And like, I can just forget about like whether or not they're trying to be rappers. Like, this is some fucking like pretentious ass art shit, but I just think that's cool. Like, they kind of break a barrier for me where I'm consuming music a little bit differently. Cause like, you know, I always think of music like that. All right, if I'm feeling this, I'm going to listen to this. If I'm feeling that, I'm going to listen to that.
Yeah.
But it's kind of dope to like listen to something where it's not so much about like setting a mood and like, I don't know, maybe it makes me nostalgic of like who I am, I guess, or like experiences I've had in my life. Mm-hmm. And it's not even really about the music. It's just like, it's something different.
Mm-hmm.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Am I fucking bullshitting
over
here?
No, it does. It does. Totally.
So, I don't know. Well, yeah. Like,
I'm obviously not the most educated person on genres of music and everything like that. I just think
the middle era,
it's funny how much comedy now is being integrated in things and how people aren't taking themselves as seriously.
Now it's about like an artist being themselves versus being built up to be somebody kind of thing. There's so much of artists now, like when they get interviewed by Nardwuar and when they go on interviews about this and that, and even GQ, like that, you see that video they did with Denzel Curry?
I didn't watch it, no.
But like, you saw that, it was 10 things you can't live without. Yeah. And like, he was just talking about like super like normal shit. I chuckle because he's like, I guess he's like a huge Uno fan.
Mm-hmm.
And he kind of like goes on a rant. He's like, yo, you should be able to stack plus twos in Uno, bro. And he starts like talking about it. I just know why I felt compelled to tweet at him. I'm like, if you play it on the computer, it's like that. And a bunch of people were like, what the fuck are you talking about? He like liked it. So I'm like, oh, that's cool. Like,
that is pretty cool.
Maybe now he'll like go play Uno and like he'll be curious about it and be like, oh shit. Like,
we ain't good. I'm a fat man. Feet are chewing drugs like Pac-Man. TMG on your walk, man. You ain't fucking with it. You can take a walk, man. Take a walk. Take a walk. You don't want to push my buttons. Take a walk. Take a walk. Take a walk. You don't want to push my buttons. Take a walk. Man.